imagine, if you will, a post-apocalyptic world. A dystopian world. No, a part post-apocalyptic, part dystopian world, where the once separate governments across the globe joined together to form one new world order, whose goal is to turn the human race into slaves, to reduce them to a very base level of existence. And they accomplish this over the course of decades, centuries even, by outlawing everything and anything that people once enjoyed, their freedoms, their comforts, forms of entertainment. Well, my friend, you don't have to imagine that, because that is exactly what's going to happen. How do I know this? Because I have proof, hard evidence, which is why I've asked you to meet me here, and why I'll be meeting with other like-minded individuals, such as yourself, that I can trust. Allow me just a moment. I know you've seen the news reports. Can't miss it, really. How that Dr. Clemmons of Arkham Sanitarium has somehow managed to gain political power, a political seat and influence, and how he has begun to plant seeds in the minds of all the world leaders meeting with each political leader in each country. Talks of bringing all the governments of the world together, and that may sound benign and harmless, but after what I have uncovered, it is anything but. And again, that's why I've asked you to meet me here. I want to counter what they plan to do. I want to build, with your help and the help of others, the foundation of a resistance, which is another reason that I've asked you to meet me here. Now, I know you're probably wondering, how do I know this? What's the evidence that I have? Well, allow me to show you. I was able to, how should we say, gain access to Mr. Clemmons' office. Political office in Washington, and that is where I discovered this binder and the evidence and information contained within, which shows the plans shocking and very surreal. I couldn't believe it when I first laid eyes on it myself. Now, I know you're probably wondering why. How did I gain access to his office? Why am I here involved? Well, it's because I want to do something. I feel driven. I feel like it's my calling to find out what's really going on with these plans for this new world order and the foreseeable events that will follow the riots. It's only a matter of time once they begin to implement what I'm about to show you. Once their plans, their true plans, come to fruition. This is apparently just a mock-up or a draft, not the final version. But nonetheless, is straight from Clemmons' office, and I wasn't sure exactly what to do with this. Do I want to leak it to the press? I don't really know. I think for now it's best that no one knows that, besides you and some of the others that I'll be meeting with that I can trust, that no one knows that this exists besides Professor Clemmons and the fact that he may have misplaced it. I was able to make copies of it and swap the originals. So, what I'm about to show you here is probably the most frightening thing that you will ever witness in your entire life. But this is what will lead to the downfall, enslavement of the human race. We might not be able to prevent or stop the new world order from forming, but I have my own plans, which is, again, why we're here, to counter whatever the N.W.O.'s plans are, which, well, allow me to show you. This is what they are calling the roadmap to a better future. There are 2 years worth of this roadmap. I said, apparently this is just the early stages of what they plan to do, and perhaps beyond the first 2 years, who knows what's going to happen, but based on this alone, can't be anything good, and it can only get worse. So, the New World Order roadmap. Better future. Year 1, months 1 through 6. So once this new world order takes over, headed up by that Professor Clemmons, this is what they plan to do. exactly what that means. They're going to ban sugar that you can buy in the supermarket. Sugar cane that grows naturally. This is all I have. It's not more. There isn't any more detail beyond this. But I can only guess at this stage it's going to happen. The second month, they're going to ban money. I can only imagine what the riots that are going to occur, and everyone that supports capitalism, material possessions, how are you going to obtain food and all of that? What's going to happen to people's life savings? How are people going to get paid? What's going to happen if they ban money? Month three, this is... I thought those were bad. They're going to ban sandwiches. Can you imagine that? Banning pastrami sandwich, bologna and cheese sandwich. Are they going to ban the sub or the hoagie? What about the hamburger? Is it just sandwiches with lunch meat? I don't really know. But it's absolutely horrifying to think of a world without sandwiches. The fourth month, they are going to ban silly walks. I don't think the Ministry of Silly Walks is going to be very happy to hear that. What are we going to do with all the time we spent learning how to master the art of the silly walk? Month five, they are going to ban paper clips. Again, it's just mind-blowing to think that this new world order would go to such lengths as to ban paper clips. We need paper clips. We might be able to get by without sugar and sandwiches, but paper clips, how are we going to keep our loose leaf paper together? How are we going to attach a note to something if it's not a sticky note without a paper clip? What's next? Are they going to ban staples and staplers? Sick. I'm telling you, it's upsetting. I know. Month six, they are going to ban the color green. Have you ever heard of such a thing? That's why I said in the beginning, imagine a part post-apocalyptic, part dystopian world. Well, that's exactly what's going to happen. They ban the color green and paper clips. Okay, well, that's just the first 6 months. Doesn't get any better from there. I'm just gonna take this out of the binder, make it a little easier to show you, to go through. Off. that most likely is going to be the, what do they call it? The turning point, or what pushes people over the edge. The handlebar, banning handlebar mustaches, that's just insane. What kind of evil, twisted mind would think to do that? Month 8, the snacks ban. What's your favorite snack? Well, imagine. Gone. Outlawed. Whether it's crackers, potato chips. I just imagine every type of snack out there on the market. No longer accessible. And this is why I've decided to go on this mission. And why I've asked you here. We'll get into it in just a little bit. Month 9, they're going to ban math. Now, math, for me personally, was never my strong suit. But, I mean, let's face it, we need math. Count our money. Well, in this new world, we won't have money to count, and we won't be able to count it even if we did. But now we need math to build, to measure, so many different reasons, and they're going to ban it. Again, it's just inconceivable to think about. Month 10, they're going to ban sitting. What are we going to do? All day, or at work, or at least those that have office jobs. How are we going to watch professional sports? Stand the whole time? How are we going to enjoy playing video games? Or watching a movie in a movie theater? Standing. It's just, again, I know, you're probably just, I know the look of surprise and disgust on your face. That's exactly how I felt when I laid eyes on this the first time. Month 11, they are going to ban socks and sandals, which I don't really think is too bad. I think that's probably something that we all could agree on that need to be banned. But again, people do have the freedom to wear, and should have the freedom to wear, socks with their sandals if they like, despite how horrendous and horrific such a sight is. So, while it may be a good thing, it's not right. And month 12, they're going to ban alcohol. That's if the money ban, or the handlebar mustache ban, or the color green ban doesn't cause people to riot. Well, banning alcohol surely will. How are people going to enjoy social events, family gatherings without alcohol? How are they going to enjoy a meal at a restaurant, or meet someone at a bar without alcohol? Well, again, some people might think that's a good thing. A lot of folks, especially those that enjoy alcohol, probably going to think that's a terrible thing. So, well, that concludes the first year. So you can see why I said, once this new world takes over and they begin their plans to turn us all into slaves and to outlaw our freedoms and the things that we enjoy, the world's going to turn into dystopian seem to be in a little state of shock from everything you've just witnessed so far. Are you sure you want to continue and look at year two? Yeah, you still have some of the strength left. Okay. All right. Cosmetics. walks of life. I'm sure they'll be pouring in the streets, just setting everything on fire. Once that ban happens, not to mention the people that do special effects for movies or on TV. There's that aspect as well. Stage performers, circus performers, etc. It's just, I know, it's horrifying to just think about. Month 6. Hate to even say this. Trying to find the strength here. The kitchen utensil ban. You know, it's one thing to ban alcohol, tobacco, the color green, the handlebar mustache, money, sugar, snacks, and all the things that we've mentioned and I've gone over and shown you so far. But to ban kitchen utensils, that those other things don't cause the world and society fall apart and crumble, that will. We need our kitchen utensils. And we are nothing without them. How are we going to scoop out spaghetti sauce from that saucepan on the stove? How are we going to flip a burger on the grill? How are we going to eat our food without a knife? How are we going to stir our and eat our soup without a spoon? And make cake without the spatula? It's just making me so mad inside. Kitchen utensil ban. Like I said, this is why I've decided to take up this cause, which I'll get to in more detail once I get through this roadmap to a better future. Okay, moving on. Final 6 months of this roadmap, or at least 2 years worth of this roadmap. I can't imagine what lies beyond. Year 2, months 7 to 12. Month 7, they're going to ban coffee. Now, I'm not a huge coffee drinker. Occasionally, I like my coffee black. I like cappuccinos. Different types. I'm not too particular when it comes to coffee, but I know a lot of folks, maybe you, love their coffee. Coffee in the morning, multiple cups throughout the day. So, coffee ban doesn't say coffee bean ban, so I'm not really sure what this entails. What does that encompass? The banning of coffee, the beans themselves as they grow naturally on the planet? Is it banning of the sale and distribution of coffee beans and coffee that you might get at your local convenience store, etc.? I don't know. But to think they're gonna ban coffee, it's just horrible. It's a human rights violation. Month 8, a standing ban. It figures if they're going to ban sitting, well, I guess the next thing is they're going to ban standing as well. So what are we supposed to do? If you can't sit, you can't stand, all I can do is, can you walk? Do you have to crawl? Do you just lay prone and lay down all the time. It's just mind-boggling. Month 9, going to ban books. How are you possibly going to ban books? Again, it's just mind-boggling. Freedom of information and all of that. We need books to learn and to be educated and to teach. And of course to entertain ourselves and to those who are writers and authors need to earn an income. But of course they'll be banning money. So I don't know how the new economy or maybe a barter system is going to work. But to think about banning books, it's just inconceivable and horrifying to think about. Month 10, going to ban the internet. Now again, it's one of those things where some people are for or against. Now, I think a lot of people would agree that banning books is a terrible idea. But banning the internet, depending on who you ask, might not be such a bad idea. Like banning sandals and socks. But again, people have the right to decide for themselves whether or not to use the internet. So, you ask me, that ban, that's not too bad. Month 11, banning food storage containers. Can you imagine that? How are we going to keep our leftovers stored in the refrigerator? Whether it's leftover mashed potatoes or peas, or chicken. And how are we going to transport our leftovers to our places of work to reheat them and eat them for lunch? It's just scary and horrifying. It makes me full of rage to think about. And yes, I do love my food storage containers, okay? Month 12, that's probably the worst ban of them all. They're going to ban ideas. Just how? How are you going to do that? How are you going to ban someone coming up with an idea? Maybe they are going to ban the execution of an idea. Not so much that you have an idea, but trying to act on it. So, like I said, it's horrifying to think about, isn't it? And you can see why. Again, I hate to repeat myself, but why I said imagine a post-apocalyptic dystopian world. Well, once this new world order comes into power and they start to implement these bans in the first 2 years, yeah, goodbye society as we know it. Just give me a moment. Put this back, put this aside. So, now that I have shown you that, I'll be showing that to everyone that I'll be meeting, like yourself. Let's get down to business, the true nature, why you're here. Since the New World Order has their plans, as I've briefly mentioned earlier, I've taken upon myself to somehow counter whatever they plan to do. I don't know how they're going to execute these bans just yet, how they're going to happen and take place. Are they going to ban things and then, you know, confiscate them and put them into, I don't know, warehouses? I don't know. But I am personally, and another, while you're here, going to keep watch on the actions and activities of this new world order, the N.W.O, once they come to power. So, what I'm trying to do is lay the groundwork for my own operation. Okay? I need, but I can't do it alone. So I need some help, some folks I can trust, like-minded individuals like yourself, who, after seeing that, will want to do something. So I don't really have a name for what I'm about, whatever, however this is going to form and take place. So right now, I'm trying to just get folks like yourself to join me, and then we'll, you know, we'll have a meeting of the minds, we'll put our heads together and think about things. Although I have my own ideas, I'm not completely closed to, you know, suggestions. But for now, what we need to do, what I need your help with, is a couple of things.
Need to keep this low key, okay? That's all.
resistance or insurgency. Nothing like that. This is more of some counterintelligence monitoring. And here, you can take these up with them right here. And the last thing I need to ask you, and I'm going to be asking some folks who join me in this effort, I'm going to need you to gain access to where Professor Clemmons primarily works at Arkham Sanitarium. I believe whatever kind of operation or things are happening there, that he may be working with the U.S. government, I don't really know. But no formal government inspection reports have ever come out of or about Arkham Sanitarium, which is quite odd. It's almost as if that place doesn't exist. So I need you to volunteer and admit yourself to this sanitarium as a patient, okay? Just for a short time. Try to gain their trust. I don't want you to find out necessarily what they're doing up there at the sanitarium, their operation. That doesn't concern me. I need you to try to get as close as you can to Clemmons himself and his associates. See what you can find out about this new world order. Okay? And I will be doing the same thing. Right, but first, I need, like I said, need to get some folks like yourself to join me in this cause. Because we may not be able to stop the N.W.O. from forming. But I have my own plans, and that is if they are going to ban all of these things that I've shown you, that's on their roadmap, then what I'm thinking about doing is obtaining those things and distributing back to the folks that need them. That's only if they plan on confiscating things again. Not really sure how these bans are going to take place. It's going to be a couple years' time from now before they go into place once the New World Order forms. That it's going to happen. It's a matter of time. Okay? So, but this is the very beginning. You are getting in on the ground level. Alright, I just need your help. Hand out some flyers. Volunteer to have yourself admitted to Arkham Sanitarium. Get as close to Clemmons as you can. Keep this on the DL. And occasionally, we'll all meet together. And just keep our eyes and ears open. And follow and monitor what Clemmons and the New World Order, NWO, are doing, plan on doing. And how they're going to implement these bans. Okay? Alright. Well, I think that's enough time. I appreciate it. And thank you for joining me here and agreeing to meet me. Okay? Take those flyers. Again, distribute them. Hand them out to your closest. Those you trust in your inner circle. Those that they can trust. Etc. Alright? Now, if you'll excuse me. I've been getting some unwanted attention from a few individuals who have been trying to see what I've been doing and up to. So I need to shake them a little bit, try to lose them. So I need to go incognito. So the next time you see me, I may have a different appearance, but it's still me. So long, thanks again, and good luck, and we'll we'll be meeting again soon.